curator of In Focus Photography Exhibition, and also a mom to three little humans. So I started my photography career actually as a painter. Someone recommended to me to take photography in high school, and I thought, like, photography is a visual art form, and when I picked up the camera, it was like, if I could take this out. When I picked up the camera, I absolutely fell in love, and my photographic journey continued at the U of A, where I studied my Bachelor of Fine Arts, and I really dove into mixed media, painting onto my photographs, sewing onto them, creating fashion, conceptual fashion, and then photographing those in different locations. And for me, I've always been a passionate believer in photography as art. And so for me, like, getting into just really pure fine art, conceptual photography, where it's so much about the idea. So, like, this photo series is called A New Kind of Beauty. And in it, I photographed all of this in camera, super macro lenses, and just double exposures, and really investigated my idea of multiculturalism, because within my own family, we have four different ethnicities. So for me, I have continued my work with photography in many, many, many veins. I've been a wedding photographer, commercial. I even shoot legal photography for court cases. Still do that to this day because it pays the bills, yay. But I moved to New Zealand, that's where this photograph was taken, and I worked for fashion magazines, photographing amazing spreads in amazing locations. And what caused me to move home was I got pregnant and I wanted to have my family here in cold Edmonton. I'm really sharing this as my photo journey. So this first photograph represents a exploration of photography through grief and sadness, and I use the Holga camera because my experience of motherhood was not picture perfect, we could say. One of my children passed away at birth, and I didn't know how to process that reality except by picking up my camera. So I photographed and documented these 6 weeks of testing before my son Zachary passed away, and I photographed the first few months afterwards. I used the Holga camera. If anybody knows about that camera, it's faulty, light seeps in, can't always get focused. But to me, that was a beautiful metaphor for how I felt in that grief state. I was out of control, and after that, those first few months of photographing, I really felt like I lost myself as a person, as an artist, and I call that year after my year of distraction, because I did everything but face my grief, and making art of any kind felt dangerous. It was only when I got pregnant again that I realized if I don't face these feelings, I'm going to carry them forever. And that's where I found art and creativity, photography, to be an amazing outlet, an amazing escape, a healthy escape. And so I started to photograph my childhood marbles. And to me, they were like both macro and micro. To me, they look like both the atoms that we're made of, as well as the planets that surround us. And it was a beautiful season of childlike play that really helped pull me out of that dark time of grief. And my work went on to evolve so that it's not just about telling my story, but it's about telling the stories of other people as well. And this series is called The Quiet Rebuild. And the people who are in these pictures are volunteers who I met online. You can meet volunteers online, you can meet your husband online. Online's fun, right? So I put a call out and said, really blatantly, have you been through something difficult? And if so, would you want to be a part of this portraiture experiment? And truly, it is a creative collaboration. Often myself and the person in the photographs cry beforehand, we're vulnerable. And by exhibiting this work, it's been an amazing gift. And I feel like it's a legacy that my son has given me, is this ability to help other people tell their stories. And so showing this work, it also opens the opportunity for the viewers to reflect on their own lives and think about the resiliency of the human spirit, which is something that is so beautiful and inspiring to me. So in the effort of supporting my local community, and I mean here in Edmonton and beyond, all Canada, I'm including in that. My husband and I started In Focus Photography Exhibition and Awards. It began as an idea across a restaurant table where we were talking about reflecting on my career. I've been a photographer for 17 years, which makes me sound old. But we were wondering, like, what can we do? What can we do to help other people, to help propel careers forward, to give a platform for showing emerging and contemporary work of amazingly talented people in our country? And so that's where In Focus Photography was born. And we have our fifth show on right now. The theme is connection. You can go out to the Renaissance Edmonton Airport Hotel and see some really breathtaking work. We have this exhibition, we have portfolio reviews, but at the heart of it, the idea is to give back, to create community, to support each other. And really, truly, this is my passion project. And I know there's a lot of photographers who are in our show here in the room, so thank you so much for sharing your work and your vision with the world. So I am immensely grateful for your time.